Hi, I'm Stargate Pioneer from Better Podcasting, a proud member of the Gonna Geek Network, just like the show you're listening to now. The opinions expressed are those of each individual host. Check out all the other podcasts at GonnaGeekNetwork.com and get ready because geekiness begins in 3, 2, 1.
You have been granted clearance by Director Jeffrey Mace. Stand by for S.H.I.E.L.D. debriefing. All information to be discussed here is classified and may only be discussed among agents granted clearance by the S.H.I.E.L.D. director.
Now it's time for your scheduled debriefing. I'm Director Stargate Pioneer.
I'm Agent Haley.
And I'm Agent Lauren.
Welcome to Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D. It's a Marvel Comic Universe fan show. This show is recorded on Wednesday, February 1st, 2017. Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D. is a fan-based podcast on the ABC television show Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., Marvel's Daredevil Jessica Jones, and Luke Cage on Netflix, the Marvel Cinematic Universe, and the Marvel Comic Universe in general.
Because of Quack.
If you'd like to talk to us about Quack, you can get a hold of us. You can get a hold of us at our website, legendsofshield.com.
You can leave us a voicemail line at 844-THE-BUS-1 or 844-843-2871.
You can visit our Facebook page, Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D. Podcast.
You can find us on Twitter at Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Our video streams can be found at our YouTube channel. That's youtube.com/GunnaGeek.
Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D. is a proud member of the GunnaGeek.com network.
This time on episode 160 of Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D., we're going to be starting our next giveaway on our X-Men Marvel Collector Core Crate. We're going to be talking about Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Hot Potato Soup. We're going to be talking a little bit about the weekly Marvel news, your feedback, and highlights from the live chat room at www.geeks.live. Ladies, we gave away the vaunted Coulson poster last week. It's going to be sent off in the mail later this week. I got the snail mail address for Calvin. It's going to be going off in just a day or so, and this week we're going to be giving away the X-Men crate. So, Haley, what do people have to do to get it?
Well, this week it is an awesome X-Men crate, so we decided to do something that involves the X-Men, and what we would like is for you to call in and give us your very best Gene. Remember, our voicemail line is 844-THE-BUS-1. That's 844-843-2871. And for bonus points, you can let us know your favorite time that Jean Grey was kidnapped and or killed.
And since we're running this in conjunction with the Legion premiere, which is on February 8th, 2017 on Fox, we're going to be...
Fox or FX?
It's FX. That's right. It's Fox Family, but FX. We're going to be running this until, let's say, our first recording in March, so the 1st of March, 2017. So that gives you guys 4 weeks to get your emails in or your voicemails in with your Gene and your bonus points.
Yeah, that would not win, that one right there.
No, that would really suck.
It needs to be, like, at least 5 times more dramatic.
And so much angst.
Yes.
Oh, I hate angst.
Just take all your angst and all your repressed, like, you know, like, stuff and throw it in there.
What repressed? Like, stuff? Okay.
All right. So we're looking forward to that on March 1st, 2017. Oh, by the way, we got a couple of late entries into the Coulson poster, even though we were running it for like 5 or 6 weeks. Somebody didn't make the cut in terms of the deadline, and that would be at Badger Spoon on Twitter.
No partial credit.
No. Nope. Sorry, Badger. You lost, but we'll read your entries anyway. He said, best Coulson moment, accidentally revealing Captain America undies on Ultimate Spider-Man.
That was pretty fantastic. It was in the first season, if I remember right.
I think so as well. And then, since I opened it up to like everything Coulson or Clark Gregg, he said, best Clark Gregg moment? And guess what that was?
Was it the lip syncing?
It was totally Britney Spears.
Yes.
Yeah, so very good, Badger. You might have been in the running had you made the deadline, but you did not. So make sure you make the deadline for this one. Make sure you give us your voicemail, or I'll take your audio file too. Just email it to me. But voicemail, Jean! And then for bonus points, the favorite time that Jean Grey was kidnapped or died. Now it's time to move on to the actual main event. We're talking about Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Here we go. This episode, Hot Potato Soup, was directed by a relative newcomer to the director corps. She's got 8 credits since 2012, and her name is Nina Lopez-Corrado. And the credits here are pretty good. Haley, read off her credits that she's got so far.
She did 1 episode of The Mentalist, 1 of Frequency, 3 of Supernatural, 1 of The Librarians, 1 of NCIS New York, and this episode of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Hot Potato Soup.
So I thought you'd appreciate the 3 episodes of Supernatural.
Yeah. What season were they in?
Actually, they were relatively recent. They were in 2016, so last season.
Okay.
I saw the episode of The Librarians she did on, it was on New Year's Day, I think. And I was at a friend's house and we were watching it, and it was quite fun. So good job.
I think she did a great job. I think they brought in somebody that's very competent and that can pull off a great episode, which I enjoyed this week. Now, it was written, she was helped by a great script, because it was written by our favorite writer, Lauren.
Craig Titley. We just like saying his name. But no, he's actually has 9 credits as a writer, including Conspiracy Theory. Did we land on the moon? Yes.
Did we?
Yes. We totally did.
Run, Scooby-Doo, Cheaper by the Dozen 1 and 2, Percy Jackson and the Olympians, 2 episodes of Clone Wars, 2 episodes of The Cape, and 7 episodes of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., including 4,722 hours, The Inside Man, Emancipation, Uprising, and Hot Potato Soup.
Absolutely.
Oh, The Cape.
Well, you got to get your, you know, feet underneath you somewhere. You got to admit, Cheaper by the Dozen, I like that. Every time we talk about Craig, I'll bring it up. Cheaper by the Dozen and Cheaper by the Dozen too. But what really caught my eye was Star Wars, The Clone Wars, which I have not had time to watch. I am barely caught up to Star Wars Rebels, which is so good this year, by the way. It is so good. I meant to talk to you about it before, Lauren. It's awesome. So we'll have to talk about that online. But yeah. These episodes of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., Afterlife, 4,722, Uprising, and then this episode, Hot Potato Soup, they bring in Craig when they need a great writer that's not necessarily on staff in the production suite or the production suite. Hot Potato Soup. I heard this title last week when we were preparing the show notes. I was like, what is that? And then I saw the little teaser at the end of the episode. Okay, it's Hot Potato with the Darkhold. I didn't get the soup completely. So
I couldn't sleep last night, and my mind actually spent way too much time thinking about this. So the Darkhold is, of course, the Hot Potato. Them trying to hide it is Project Hot Potato or Operation Hot Potato or whatever they call it. And it gets smashed in that the plan goes to crap. But they are able to salvage some of it in that, you know, they find out some useful information. So you take those smashed remains and you make something useful out of it, which is, I guess, soup. It was like 3 in the morning. I was really tired, you guys.
I buy it.
And yeah. I'm kind of hungry and I want soup now.
That's good. That's good. I mean, I had hot potato soup a couple of weeks ago. I forget what it was called, the mix, the bear something or other.
Bear Creek?
Yeah, Bear Creek. And it was pretty good. I enjoyed it. I'm not usually a hot potato soup guy. I'm more of a wedding soup or a good turkey soup after you've had a turkey, you know, for Thanksgiving or Christmas or something like that. You make turkey soup. That's the kind of guy I am. But hot potato soup everywhere. Oh, and New England clam chowder. Oh, I love a good New England clam chowder. I know.
I'm sorry, but clams are horrible, horrible creatures.
I don't know why.
I can't eat them.
I don't know why I like them, but I do. So there's that. And yeah. So Haley, what's your favorite soup since we're talking about favorite soups?
I do like a good potato soup. There's actually a, you know, like Panera Bread type place here that makes a really good potato soup.
Oh,
not and the, Panera, but yeah.
And the soup at Olive Garden, all of those are good.
Way okay. too loaded with salt.
That's true. But yeah. Yeah.
No, like a good potato soup, a good tomato soup, like the really good, like homemade.
Ooh, yeah.
There's a pizza place near here that does a really good homemade tomato basil soup. Oh, so good.
Guys, what are we talking about soup for? Because we have.
Now I'm hungry.
Because it's hot potato soup.
We've got Koenigs to talk about. Oh my gosh. We got soup. Sam. We got Billy. We got LT. They even put in Eric in there. And then Thurston.
And Thurston.
This was great. This was amazing. And Patton Oswalt did a great job of playing all these characters.
When they brought in a fourth Koenig, I was like, for sure, they've got to be LMDs. Like, come on, this is getting ridiculous.
Them trolling us right there at the end was wonderful. They're like,
yes,
LMD. Yeah, we were working on the project. Oh, did you think we're...
No.
Like, oh, and then of course in their job about the clones, it's like all the clone DNA, the, what was it when LT's talking about like growing up with all those brothers and she's like, yeah, the
enough genetic material to make a clone army. Yeah. Programmed.
And everyone's just giving them looks.
Right. We're programmed to take pain and that sort of thing. But okay, we're talking about LMDs, Koenigs. Guess what? Batty, who we called Dr. Radcliffe Batty because of his time on Spartacus. Let's just get that over with right here. Batty actually now has a brain mapping of one of the Koenigs. So he could totally make a Koenig LMD now.
And then we could have it be like, you know, the Grey Goose scenario with nanites, only with Koenigs. So the world would be nothing but Koenigs. I think we're ready for that.
I'm sure. Oh, but at the beginning, with
the world will not end in fire. It will end in Koenigs.
So at the beginning, Sam and Billy are quoting geek shows left, right, and backwards. That was fun to watch.
If there's anyone you want to see just quote geek stuff off the top of their head, it's Patton Oswalt. I mean, all you got to do is watch his stand-up, and he's so good at it. Like that whole, what was it, that like 45-minute extemporaneous thing on Parks and Rec that he did about how he fixed the prequels?
I think it was only like 12 minutes, but he did just do it off the top of his head. They were like, we need you to just talk for a long time, and we're just going to pull like 30 seconds from it.
Yeah.
So just go and start and finish, and you know, we'll pull some stuff out of the middle. It'll be fine. And he just like went.
It was amazing.
I miss that show, Parks and Recreation. I would have welcomed him back to that show. That was
like, I have to wonder if the part about Quake Black Widow fan fiction was him just going.
I don't know, but it is out there. I've seen it. I haven't written it
yet.
For those who are questioning on Twitter, I haven't written any Quake fanfic, but I read it. So yeah,
we did have a question on that from Andy Mingna, at least said, hey, Lauren, are you responsible for some of this fanfic?
Sadly, I am not, but I mean, I'm just very busy lately, so I have not had time to write fanfic as much as I want to.
And do you think Sam wrote some of that fanfic himself? Because he was quite smitten with the Quake.
Yes.
I don't know. I bet he might have done some fan art, and I bet that he moderates like a Tumblr blog that like posts good Quake fanfic.
See, I feel
because
like
he's very proud of her.
I feel like he's got one that he's written, but he hasn't posted anywhere because he's nervous about it.
If he has, I bet it's like a self-insert, but it's not like a romantic one. It's just like, him and Quake having awesome adventures and he's like her sidekick or something, uh-huh. or else he's like, you know, her Nick Fury or something.
No, he's the Nick Fury for Quake and Black Widow.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so LT, let's move on to LT. We finally see the Koenig sister, who is the ringleader of them all.
So this actress, I love her. She's on It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia as this character named Artemis, which that's the actress's name, Artemis Pevnacki. And she's hilarious. She's a comedian. She's also been on Drunk History. She's great.
Oh, that's right.
And the thing is, like, every time I see her, even as, you know, badass as she was on this show, every time I see her, I keep thinking of some of the lines that she says on It's Always Sunny. It sounds like the horrible, like, making out with Danny DeVito. And I'm insanely high on mescaline and some of the other things that I can't say on this show because you'll have to edit it out. But no, she's a fantastic actress. And I was so happy to see her and especially to see her being badass.
Yeah, it was great. And, oh, guys, by the way, let's do a little Koenig crush here. Are you guys ready?
I like how they had to keep their arms, like, awkwardly out for the CG to work out right.
Yeah. But it works at the same time because Koenigs are awkward.
Yep. But it was funny.
Well, now, the reason that they were there is Coulson gave the Darkhold to them so that they could hide it. And knowing that they were very experienced how to do that, going back and forth, whatever, they just so happened to kidnap the last guy that actually had them, which was Billy, who, oh, Billy, he had his puppy taken away.
That was sad. Like, he just wanted his little, like, it was so sad.
It was. But did you guys catch the town that the library, the Labyrinth, was in, by the way? Did you catch the name of the town? It was Pleasant Hill. Yep, we're talking about Avengers standoff event from 2016. And the thing that Maria Hill botched with Kobik. And it was in Pleasant Hill. So this is that fictitious Marvel town that they made to be a prison. So it does have history in the comics, at least recently. I don't know if it has past history or not, but it was in Pleasant Hill. So there's your comic book connection that SP was able to make this week.
Good catch. Good catch.
Yeah, there you go.
Also, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. seems to be farming from the same talent pool as most of the CW shows at this point. Mm-hmm. Russian bad guy was on the 100 last season.
Are you talking the big Russian bad guy that's doing most of the talking? He's also on Black Sails.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. Well, he's the superior because he's the superior man. So he's the guy that, spoilers, by the way, for those that didn't figure it out during the episode, he's Anton Ivanov, I believe is the character's name. And he doesn't believe the Inhumans should be allowed to exist because they didn't labor for their great power. They did not drink the vodka with the onion after sniff. And more importantly, he wants to get rid of Coulson, who is at the center of all these alien and inhuman things.
Yeah, I mean, okay. Watching that, I'm like, I could see where he would think that, because he is kind of like, you know, a Men in Black figure. But on the other hand, and I said this on Twitter, someone needs to tell this guy that correlation does not equal causation. Like, Coulson is not the reason the MCU exists. The MCU exists. At first, I was like, oh my God, they're going to go like kill Stan Lee. But no, they went with Coulson.
Hey, this guy keeps showing up at all these things. A minor character who happens to be at all these terrible events.
Yeah, this little old guy keeps showing up. And he seems really important. And everyone always seems to know who he is. And he always looks the same. But he's different people. See, that seems more suspicious to me.
It is. But, and there's a whole fan theory about that, right? Because
there's a bunch of people who think he's the Watcher.
Right.
But
I have a new theory.
Oh,
he's the first LMD, the one that they worked on.
The Koenigs. That would be cool to get him in a cameo in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. because he has not been in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. yet, right?
No, I don't believe so.
Yeah, we need to get him in a cameo in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. That would be perfect. That would be awesome. That would be great. Oh, good call, Haley.
Well, I'm here.
Yep.
And once again, Marvel, these ladies are available for your writing room. Come up with story ideas, one-shot ideas, that sort of thing, because we haven't had a good one-shot in a while. So go ahead, hook them up, and I will take a... I'll actually reduce a 15% finder's fee. We'll go with that.
I think that sounds fair. Oh, what did I tell y'all about the brain mapping and stuff?
I had totally forgotten that they had mapped May's brain when they did that other thing.
I forgot about it too, but yeah, going back, it's like, okay, so that's how. All right.
Oh, guys, guess what? Consultant Black Adam just totally spanked us in the chat. He said Stan Lee had a cameo, Trax, in season one.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
It's okay. He can have another one.
And that's what Black Adam said. It's okay. It'd be good to see him in the show again. Trax. I think that was that the first episode that you and I did, Haley, on Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D.? I think it might have been.
No, I think it was Yes Man, wasn't it?
Yeah. Well, Mac likes to hear robots scream. Who would have thought?
He is not a fan of the robots.
And we got Shotgun Axe again this episode as well. That was
Shotgun Axe, I feel like it needs a name. You know, other than Shotgun Axe.
Like Vera?
I feel like it's a bad idea. Like, it just looks like you're always about to cut your hand.
But it's Mac, so he's not going to.
I know, I'm just saying, like, if he pumps that and his hand slips a little bit, there's an axe blade there now.
See, what I would do is I would, you know, try to pick it up, drop it on my foot, and be down a foot.
Or I feel like, you know, Fitz is going to do that. Like, Mac's going to get knocked unconscious, drop the shotgun, and Fitz is going to pick it up and try and help and lose a finger.
Season one Fitz, maybe. Season now Fitz. I think he's kind of doing a bit better.
Simmons wouldn't. Simmons would be a total badass. But I feel like Fitz still might drop the shotgun on his foot.
It was good to see it. We didn't see Yo-Yo. We didn't see Mace. We didn't see Lola. But we did get to see the bus. I'm just going to call it the bus. You know, you guys can live with it out there. Zephyr 1. And
have we had complaints?
I don't. Not yet. But as long as I keep on saying it, I know somebody's going to correct me. It's not the bus anymore. It's Zephyr 1. Well, yeah, whatever. Boom. I'm going to call it the bus.
Forever.
There you go. And we did not get actual May in this episode. She's still locked up on the submarine, I'm guessing. I don't know. Where do you guys think she is?
They have to have moved her. So, yeah, I would guess she's probably hanging out in the submarine. Or if there's another, you know, Robo Radcliffe out there, maybe he's with her.
Yeah. Do you think that this is the real Dr. Batty, or do you think this is LMD Dr. Batty in the submarine?
I think this is the real one.
Yeah, you never know. But once those LMDs start flying around, you don't know. Because we do have one more out there, supposedly, allegedly, right? Because he said there was another. Was it himself? Or
that's what I had assumed. I had assumed that the third one was himself.
See, I thought
we'll see.
I thought it was another one. But yeah, we'll see. We'll see. What'd you guys think of LMD May this episode?
So sad.
They finally kissed. Oh.
Yeah, we get Felinda confirmed, except she's a robot. And then, like, immediately after, as like, soon as they kiss, I'm like, oh no, this is about to go real bad. And
I was walking on the treadmill, right? And Phil was actually saying, oh, you're an LMD. And I was actually on the treadmill. I was fist pumping. I was like, yes, yes, I called it. But I guess he just came to that conclusion right then and there. I don't think he's known the entire time like I had thought he did. Blinded by love again, Coulson.
Yeah, he seemed really upset. And then she seemed really upset because you could tell she didn't want to be doing what she was doing. And then as soon as Radcliffe came, she's like, you know, take me with you, because she doesn't. It hurts too much to stay. And he's like, you weren't built to last. Like, oh, cold.
And then they have their little Terminator fire at the end.
Yeah, and Coulson can't bring himself to burn Robo May.
Can you blame him?
information.
Yeah. You can make her better again. Kinda, sorta. Well, here's hoping we get the real Melinda May back, because she's already died once. Be terrible to bring her back like that. Terrible. Oh, she wasn't built to last.
It made me think of the replicants from Blade Runner.
Yeah, and that's coming out later this year, I believe. The Blade Runner sequel, after like 45 billion years, we get a sequel to it.
Yeah, I'm not sure how much I care about the sequel at this point. Like, I like the original, but it's like, why are they doing this?
It's like,
hey, isn't the Avatar sequel coming out this year too?
I think they're starting
again,
to film
why
it.
Why are they doing this?
I know. All right, so let's talk about Fitz and his daddy issues and his glorious ability to figure out what the heck was going on inside LMD Batty.
Yeah, we get more sadness. It's just been a really bad time for Fitz all around. And then we get Robo Batty screwing with his head. Just like, oh, I know your dad and we're friends and we talk all the time. And Fitz is just not here for this because his dad walked out on him as a kid. And then we have, you know, poor Gemma trying to like help him out and make him feel better. But because, you know, they work so well as a team, he's able to use that to like think sideways and figure it out because they're awesome together. And they like rely on each other to work. And that's why I love them as a couple. I have so many feelings, you guys.
You need a minute?
A little bit.
It was a strong science baby episode. This episode was strong and it hit on all cylinders. It started bringing some stuff together. There's still some mystery out there of how it's going to go. Like Senator Nadir wasn't in there. Her brother is still dead on the bottom of the ocean, supposedly encased and getting better, I guess. We'll see what's going on with that. And by the way, Talbot and his mustache, neither of which were actually in the episode. And I believe, I can't remember who it was, but somebody, I'm going to summon you here. Somebody said that Talbot's mustache was an LMD. Which I can actually believe, because have they found the mole yet? I don't think they found the mole.
It's not a mole, it's a mustache.
Right. But what was it actually the Ada head that was sensing inside?
It was May.
Yeah.
Oh.
At first I thought it was Radcliffe, but... it makes sense if it's, you know, May funneling information back.
See, they're like not Robo-May. Clearly delineating this stuff and coming to resolution. So you got to think about it. And I'm not so good with thinking about things when I'm trying to watch my entertainment. Go figure.
You know, if Talbot's mustache is an LMD, it's not very convincing on the lifelike part.
Maybe that was the first model that the Koenigs worked on.
That's why they had to scrap the project. They're like, nobody's going to believe this is a real mustache.
And then they just gave it to Talbot. Like, as a birthday gift.
It was, like, on a shelf next to the Groucho Marx glasses, and he thought it was, like, part of a real disguise.
And maybe a clown nose next to it, too.
They just glued it on his face while he was asleep.
And it won't come off. Pastepot Pete helped with it, and now it's stuck forever.
The last note that I have on this episode is the Resistance, the Watchdog leader, who's played by John Piper Ferguson. He got his wrist seriously broken by Ada.
Yep, that's why. Look, you don't punch robots. They are robots. They are metal. Even if they look like they have skin on them, they are metal.
Yep,
don't hit robots.
They didn't know she was a robot, though, at the time. And when she said, "Your tone sounds threatening," it was like such an even keel, low. I'm mad at you, but I'm not going to tell you I'm mad at you, and I'm just going to punch my fist through your chest cavity.
Look, there's a reason I play ranged DPS in games. So.
Right. All right, Lauren, you got anything that I haven't covered yet?
Thurston Koenig cracked me up with his little faux hawk and his sheeple shirt, and calling everyone sheeple.
Shield stormtroopers have got to go. This is a peace palace.
He was great.
He was.
He reminds me of a friend of mine.
You got anything, Haley?
No, I didn't take notes this week, so I don't have anything.
All right. It was a good episode. Haley, did you think it was a good episode?
Yes. If they want to bring back Koenig every week to talk about what fan fiction is out there, I am all in.
Right? Like, maybe this is the way to bring us into, like, a Ms. Marvel show. Like, they meet through a forum.
Yes.
Or, like, a Tumblr or something.
Yeah, that would work. Ms. Marvel would also work in the Netflix universe. It's too dark for her, but, I mean, she lives in New York, doesn't she?
Yeah, she could also work on, you know, Freeform or something like that. They're doing Cloak and Dagger, and I feel like Ms. Marvel would be a great fit for that, too.
Yeah, she would be a better fit show. For Cloak and Dagger. Where's Cloak and Dagger set again?
New York. They're all set in New York.
Isn't Cloak and Dagger part of the mutant stuff?
No.
No? Okay.
No.
I know for a while the rights on that one were in question, I thought. But
they
I don't
are
remember.
Back with Marvel.
Okay.
All right, well, next week we get season 4, episode 12. Boom! Yeah, that's the name of the episode. Boom!
I wonder if something's going to happen in that episode.
I wonder if something's going to go boom! So we'll see. And in the meantime, we're going to move on to some news. All right, we have kind of an abbreviated news segment this week, just a couple of stories. First of all, we have some Cloak and Dagger cast information.
Yeah, so you remember last week when it was rumored that we were going to get Cloak and Dagger casting? Well, now it's confirmed. Olivia Holt and Aubrey Joseph have landed the leads. Olivia Holt, I can't remember if she was the one that we talked about last week.
I think we did.
Yeah, but... Aubrey Joseph was not. He's in Run All Night. He's most recently been seen in The Night Of, which is fantastic. And yeah, I'm really excited to have this casting because, like, now that we have casting, we can start filming. And once we start filming, we get the show. So
that's right. And another Netflix series that has been in works for a while, Iron Fist, we have some directing news for that.
Yes, this made me so happy when I saw it. So, you know how Nick and all that played a really big part in Luke Cage?
Mm-hmm.
So, Wu-Tang Clan did a lot of work with Luke Cage, and RZA actually is going to be directing an episode of Iron Fist, episode 6. And I went to go see his debut, The Man with the Iron Fist, like his directorial / writing debut a few years ago. I mean, it wasn't great, but it was fun. And he's done a few more since then. And he's, you know, super into martial arts and kind of the 70s kung fu stuff. Like, it's really clear in his music videos and his music. And again, in Man with the Iron Fist. So I'm really excited to see how this works with him directing this episode.
Iron Fist, I'm looking forward to. It's great going through all the Netflix series, and I can't wait to get through Luke Cage. So Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., you need to have some off weeks so we can progress in our Luke Cage rewatch here. And then finally, we're going to talk about some Square Enix Marvel news.
Yeah, so a couple days ago, there was like, oh, we're going to have a big announcement from Marvel. The big announcement was apparently an Avengers project from Square Enix, Crystal Dynamics, and Eidos. You might know these companies from Final Fantasy, from Kingdom Hearts. Those are like their two biggest projects. And they released a video. They released a video on Twitter, which we're linking to. And it's, you know, very, very pretty because that's what Square Enix does. It's really pretty stuff. All you got to do is see, like, the latest Final Fantasy to see. And there's, like, Thor's hammer. And you've got, you know, Iron Man's gauntlet. And it's all kind of sparking in a puddle. And Captain America's shield. And it's an Avengers project. And everything looks kind of... And the hashtag is reassembled. So it looks like everything kind of fell apart, and we'll see what happens after. I mean, there's not a whole lot of information other than the trailer, and it's a teaser, but we'll hear more about it as it comes. Like if you're a fan of Square Enix, maybe you'll like it.
Haley, we'll do see. You have a favorite Marvel game?
I don't really play games much.
Oh, you just podcast every night of the week, right?
Not as much anymore, but most of the nights of the week.
Okay. Yeah, I really haven't had a chance to play any Marvel games. I'm actually playing Mass Effect. I know I've said I would for like a couple years now. Every Friday night, that's my Mass Effect night. So I'm
okay. Which one are you playing? What character are you playing? Who are you romancing? And what class are you playing? And who are you romancing?
Well, since this is literally my first playthrough, I'm doing the first Mass Effect on Xbox One, but it's the Xbox 360 version, and it is a femchap. Her name is Honor. Go figure. And she is a soldier because I don't know how to do the adept stuff or anything. So this will be my first playthrough, and I might actually go back and play through again. But this is the grounds of which I can relate to it.
Mm-hmm. And who are you romancing?
Well, I don't know anything. I'm like 3 hours into it.
Well, you got to think about these things. It's BioWare.
Oh, geez. See, I didn't know. You're the first person ever to tell me anything about shipping or... Oh, this is news to me okay, right now.
The big thing about BioWare games, yes, it's a beautiful story, but it's also like basically a dating sim, but you could also save the world.
Well, if I was going to... Given the characters I have around me right now, Ashley is the obvious one, but you know, I haven't gotten Natalia yet or anything like that, so I don't know.
Okay, well, in the first one, if you're FemShep, you can romance Caden or you can romance Liara. If you had a mod, if you had a PC game, you could have a mod where you could romance Ashley.
Okay.
But you're playing on console.
So I'm not going to romance Caden because the guy kind of creeps me out a little bit. So
okay. So Liara then.
It'll be Liara once I get
okay,
to her.
Okay, Liara's pretty good. She annoyed me my first playthrough, but I like her a lot more now. She's who I'm romancing this playthrough.
Oh, cool. What game are you on right now?
I'm working on two, but I'm also, I've also been sucked into Overwatch.
Right.
So I'm playing a whole lot of Overwatch.
Right. But you're on two. I'm on one. Yes. So it'll be months before I get to two.
Playthrough.
Yeah. Right. Okay. All right. Well, so this ends the Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D. Mass Effect talk, and we're going to move on now.
Ask me about Mass Effect and Overwatch and Dragon Age.
We're going to move on to some feedback here. So one of us, I'm not sure quite who, I'm thinking Lauren, asked everybody on Twitter, will you be satisfied if this is Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. last season, or are you clamoring for more? And we had several people respond to us. If you haven't responded to this yet, please let us know over on Twitter. And Andy Migna responded and he said, depending how they wrap it up, won't be sad if they get renewed for a shorter last season. And don't forget, we have that really short mid-season, I guess, in Humans, like 8 episodes or whatever. So they could do like 2 half a seasons next year. So that's a good thought, Andy. I just don't think it's coming back next year. I just don't think the ratings are deserving of it. But what do I know? I'm not an ABC executive. So Lauren, what did we have next?
We also had from @WesSanger, definitely need more.
I'm like you, but I just don't see the ratings. So like, this sucks. Plus, we've been doing the podcast on it for years, so kind of invested in it. Haley, what did @MrPericletes have to say?
He said, I get it if this is the end. As long as they end it well, I'm okay if this is the last season. And I feel the same way. That's where I've fallen down on this.
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much. It's unfortunate, but. We've got plenty more. The podcast, we've decided that the podcast isn't going to go away. I don't know what the end game is going to be with the podcast, but there's just so much to talk about in the Marvel Universe that we're good for quite a while. So stay tuned for more Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D. And moving on, Lauren, what else did Andy Migna have to say?
He also said... Okay, I don't remember what this is in response
okay.
to.
So he was, this is part of the live tweet or his watch through, because he watches it the next day because it's like in the middle of the night when Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is on here in the United States. He lives.
Yeah, stupid time zones.
Yeah, right. So he tweeted us and he's watching through and he said, nope, this seemingly chance for escape. This is last week's episode, by the way, with May.
Oh.
Reminds me too much of Shaw in the final season of hashtag Person of Interest. And if you've not seen Person of Interest, you might have not have gotten that reference. Andy, I totally got that reference. And that is exactly what I was thinking, too, with the whole May thing. But you can't really call it a ripoff because it's kind of a trope going all the way back to Matrix and stuff like that. So I feel you, Andy. That's what I'm saying. I feel your pain. All right, Haley, what did Mr. Pericletes have to say?
He said, well, he shared a picture with us, a meme, if you will. And it says, what timeline is this, Logan? I don't know. Ask Barry.
And it was Patrick Stewart as Professor X in the Logan trailer thing. So, yep, Barry, stop frickin' with the timeline, sir. All right, and Donna Girl, Chrissy said, I hope somebody writes a fanfic of Quake reading Quake fanfic. I think that would be kind of cool, her getting into it, but something tells me she's already into it because she's the essence of the dark web, isn't she?
Yeah, pretty much. Okay, hold on. I'm looking and I'm trying to see if there's anything yet on Archive of Our Own.
Oh, for Quack?
Yes. Well, first of Quake reading anything about... I mean, there's a lot of Coulson and May.
Okay.
There's a lot. Wow, here's Coulson and Daisy. That's...
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, they've
I don't approve of that.
They've had a lot of screen time together, so I get where somebody could go that way, but
it's such a father-daughter relationship.
It is. It creeps me out.
That's exactly what I was going to say. I couldn't go there personally.
A lot of, Grant Ward.
Yeah.
How about Skimmins?
There's still a lot of Skimmins. Okay. A lot of Fitzsimmons still.
We need a new name now that she's not Sky anymore.
Oh, I saw it the other day. It was... What was it? It was...
She doesn't like Quake.
Quimmin?
Jake? Sometimes? No.
No, that's not good.
Well, while you guys figure it out, I'm going to move on to the next one.
I saw it on Twitter the other day.
At Adana Girl also tweeted us, and she said, here is a puppy.
There it is. There it is. Here's one of Daisy finding fanfic. It's also Coulson Daisy.
Oh, yeah, we need to move on from that. Yeah.
Okay. Anyway.
So at Adana Girl, she tweeted us and she said, here is a puppy for Billy, and it is one of the dogs from Up. I do not like
it's
Dakota
Doug.
Shane. Yeah. Doug. My name is Doug.
I hid under your house because I love you.
I need to see that movie. That's a movie that should be watched once a year, and I'm like 5 years behind. So I need to watch Up again.
It's an excellent movie, but the first 5 minutes make me cry so hard.
Yeah, well, you know, it's a kid movie with parents die at the beginning, that sort of thing. So what did Black Adam have to tell us, Haley?
He said, wow, I don't even know where to start on this one.
And that is obvious because he did not get us a voicemail like he usually does. And by the way, it's a busy night now. You got 3 comic book shows on from 8 till 11, so... I get why people have issues getting us a voicemail before we record the next day. And there's Arrow tonight. So comic book shows are aplenty on TV. But yeah, it was a good episode. And the whole Koenig thing would be great. Mm-hmm. I think I would have led with the Koenigs if I was Black Adam. Definitely. And then... finally is the question from Andy Migna about Sith Witch writing fanfic, and we've already answered that, so I just wanted to highlight that again. Ladies, it's time to walk this one out. Join us next week. We will discuss the episode Boom.
Boom.
And just a little reminder.
Hey, you gotta say it.
Yeah, Boom.
Boom.
Oh.
Boom.
Go. Go ahead. I want you on the screen. I'm sorry. I overtalked both of you. So, Lauren, go ahead. Give yours.
Oh, no. I was just... Okay. Boom!
Okay. Haley?
Boom!
There you go. You can find all our live streams Wednesday nights, 9 p.m. Eastern at geeks.live.
You can find our website, legendsofshield.com.
You can find our voicemail at 844-THE-BUS-1. That's 844-843-2871.
We have a Facebook page that these ladies will respond back to you at. It is Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D. Podcast.
We also have a Twitter account at Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D.
We have a sadly little used Tumblr, legendsofshield.tumblr.com,
which will soon be filled with quack fanfiction.
And there is the YouTube channel, youtube.com/GonnaGeek. Thank you very much for listening. This month has been one of the best downloaded months of Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D. history, and we really appreciate you on this journey with us, you the listener, and you watching this podcast over on YouTube. We really appreciate you downloading, listening, interacting with us, though, really is the big deal. And that's why we do this, to have a forum for everybody to come to talk about Marvel stuff. So thank you for joining us in that.
Thanks for everyone who comments on our Twitter, our Facebook, who sends us news, who talks during live tweets, who talks when they are watching the episode. We really appreciate it, and we love hearing from you.
Thank you to Badger for turning in his homework late this week. remember, we've got another giveaway going on right now for the X-Men crate. If you want to win that, you have to call and leave us a voicemail or send in a voice recording to the email. You have to let us know. Oh, you have to say Gene in a way that will make us happy, which is Gene. But you can get bonus points for letting us know what your favorite time that Gene was kidnapped and or killed.
Yeah, so that's it for this week. We had a great show. Thanks for joining us. Until next time, I'm Director Stargate Pioneer.
I'm Agent Haley.
And I'm Agent Lauren.
See you guys next week. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Boom.
Boom.
Thank you for listening. If you want to leave us feedback, go to GunnaGeek.com and you will find all our contact information and other shows. You can also visit LegendsOfShield.com where you'll find our complete archive of podcasts. The music heard on this podcast is by Kevin McLeod, found at Incompetech.com, and also artists on Pond5.com and AudioJungle.net. The opinions heard on this podcast are those of the individual hosts and do not represent Stargate Pioneer Productions, Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D., or Gunna Geek. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is the property of the Disney Corporation, Marvel Studios, and ABC. No infringement is intended. Legends of S.H.I.E.L.D. is copyright 2017.